On today's episode, we're building this great teak shoe rack. Hey, wait a minute. This sounds kind of familiar.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by SawStop, North America's number one cabinet saw. For more information, visit sawstop.com. By Highland Woodworking, fine tools delivered to your door since 1978. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. And by Lee Valley and Veritas, with over 5,000 high-quality woodworking hand tools, visit their online catalog at leevalley.com. And thanks to Pop's Cabinet Shop for a generous donation during our 2013 fundraiser. Visit Pop's Cabinet Shop's YouTube channel at youtube.com/popscabinetshop.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. On today's episode, we're finishing up the construction of this really nice teak shoe rack. In fact, it's so nice, I don't even think it belongs in the Vanderlust household. I don't know if we're allowed to have nice things like this. But anyways, I really want to thank once again our friend Jim for sending us this amazing teak. I still got plenty of leftover on the rack that hopefully I can do something else really nice, maybe for myself this time, you know, if I know what I mean. But anyways, so let's go ahead and get started right back in on where we left off last time. And where we left off last time was we finished up the milling for all the components, except for this one little piece that I kind of forgot about, and that's this nice little stretcher down here that really helps to add a good amount of rigidity to the base, so that if, say, somebody like me were kind of, I don't know, standing all over it and bouncing around, it's not going to wiggle to and fro. So without further delay, though, let's go ahead and once again get right back into where we're going to start today, which is over at the router table. Over here at the router table, I decided I am going to chamfer these ends right here to kind of square this off, and I'll even chamfer the entire body of the base. And for the top, I'm going to just chamfer the ends, but I will come back and set up a round over to do the long portions. So let's get to it. Now that I have these first edges chamfered, I want to chamfer the top and the bottom here. So I went ahead and I have this tall auxiliary fence on the miter gauge, and I'm just going to push it through, and then I'll flip it over, do that side, and then we'll do the same on this one. Now that the ends and the edges of the base are done, let's go ahead and do the ends of the top rail. And this is just going to be passing it through once and then flipping it over, passing it again, and doing it on all four edges. We'll flip it over, do it on the other end, and then we'll repeat it on the remaining seven. Now the next thing I want to do is remove the fence, and we're going to freehand this arch. Well, not really freehand it. As you can see in the footage here, I've got a nice little pin on the table, and I can use that as a nice reference to bump the piece up and then start feeding it into the actual chamfer bit. And as you can see with the chamfer bit, there's a bearing on top, so everything comes in nice and smooth. And we do one side, flip it over, we'll do the other, and then once the first base is done, we'll then move on to the second one. Now that we have all the chamfering done, let's go ahead and set the fence back up again, and we're now going to round over the corners of the long edges of the rails themselves. So it's just a matter of feeding it through, coming back, flipping it, and then feeding it through until all four corners are nicely rounded over, and then we'll just repeat it on the remaining seven.
Music.
Now that all the edge profiling is out of the way, it's time to really ramp it up and start drilling the holes for these really nice brass screws that we have. Now before we do that, I really feel I need to mention, as I was watching the footage playing back for this, it looks like the router table is really, really rocking. And to be quite honest with you, I didn't even notice it. So it must be just the camera angle. There was a little humidity that day. I did notice there was a little bit of sticking, but nothing that a little coat of wax couldn't take care of. So anyways, with that little disclaimer out of the way, let's go ahead and move on to laying out the marks for exactly where we want to drill each one of these holes so that, number one, they look uniform, and number two, it will help to keep from any splintering of the teak itself. So let's get started with laying out the holes for where the stretcher is going to attach to the base. As you can see, I've already drawn a line in here for the placement of this stretcher, and what I want to do is I want to have it down just enough from the top so that there's a little bit of clearance, and just above, I'll bring this over to see the actual arch. So I'm just going to use this piece of scrap here, give me an idea of about where I want it. So let me just go ahead and mark the actual location. It's okay if it's off just a little. I have the center line for where it's going to be placed, because it's going to be placed on center. And then for my square, I made sure that the inch mark starts right at the top of that line that I just drew using the scrap to indicate the top of it. I'm going to come down 1, 2, 3/8 of an inch, and then we'll make an adjustment so that we can do the same thing down here. And we'll come up, let's see here, 1, 2, 3. And again, I should have like a light colored pencil, but I have my marks for where I am going to pre-drill for the brass screws that are going to be coming in from the sides of the base and into the stretcher to hold it in position. So we've moved the operation over here to the drill press simply because I can. You can do this next step easily with just a hand drill and the proper size drill bit with a countersink. But I have both the bases stacked up onto each other, so we can do this in one fell swoop, I guess we could kind of say. I've got everything marked here. I've got a stop block so that it's all in position. The fence is set for this very first hole, and we're just about ready to get started on this, so let's stop gabbing. All right, I actually set my depth stop so that I wouldn't go too deep with that countersink, because I want to get a feel for how far I can. I want the screws almost flush with the surface. So let's stop there. I'm gonna do a quick test and then we'll come back. As you can see, it's still just a little proud of the surface. So I'll reset my depth stop for just a pinch more and we'll get this all dialed in. And after a little fussing with the depth stop and the drill press, here's the final result. Now to repeat the countersink on the other base, I'll leave the setup as it is and simply switch the pieces, bringing the other one to the top. Now it's a matter of double checking the alignment with the drill bit and then finish drilling through the thickness of the second piece. Once I'm all the way through, I'll flip it and countersink the show face. One set of holes done, I'll just now reposition the fence and drill the next set. Now this time, for the actual stretcher itself, I've marked 3/8 in, 3/8 in, and I've marked the center of the thickness, which in this case, it's 1 inch overall, so 1/2 inch in. We're gonna do it over here at the bench with just the hand drill. Again, kind of because we can. Now, one thing we've done is we've just switched the countersink around so that we're going to use this as a depth stop so I know how far not to go, and then we're going to try and keep this as level as possible. I'm sure I've got a little waviness in there like this, but it will compensate. We'll be fine. It's wood. All right, let's get this next one marked up. And this is where these brad point bits are great because I can get right on that mark. All right. Let's assemble. And there's the assembled base. Now we just need to add the top. Now when I go to put the top on, I want them evenly spaced. So I went ahead and I created this story stick. And I know that, let's see here, this end is going to line up perfectly with that beginning. So I'm just going to go ahead and start transferring my lines here. And that's for the top, space, and so on. So I'll continue these so that way I know exactly where to place my holes for when I drill the holes for the top rails. For these top rails, I went ahead and you can see I already started to drill this. I came in approximately 2 1/8 because that's what I want my overhang to be. And then I know the center of the base is going to be 7/16. So I carried it there. I scribed my line. I'm coming in about 1/2 inch because this is an inch thickness. And we'll just go ahead and finish. And we'll have to eyeball these to make sure we don't get them too deep. So let's go ahead and set that brad point right onto the next one. Get started. So there may be some little variation in the countersink, but this will get us almost finished here. Oops, got a little tear out there. No big deal though. So this end is done. We'll flip it, do the other end, and then finish up the others, and we're almost ready to start assembling. So it's starting to come along very nicely. What I've done is I've attached the first two pieces on the outside so that everything's ready to go. I set up this little fence, which is just simply clamped here onto my table saw, and then this way I can actually come in and register these right up against it so everything is nice and square. You can also see that I've put the screws in here into each one, and then because we went ahead and marked for where the spaces are going to go and where each one of these are going to line up, what I'm going to do is I want to mark for where I'm going to pre-drill these holes. So I'm just eyeballing the marks. If there's a little variation in here, I'm not too worried about it. I think it just will add to the character of it. But all right, so these ones are ready to go. And these first ones, I'm going to dimple the wood so I know where to come back in to drill it. There we go. Okay, so that one's ready. In fact, let's just do this. Let's set this here. And we'll just complete each one again. We'll kind of eyeball it a little bit. And this one's in position. And I'm going to continue doing this. And then, like I said, we'll pre-drill these and attach the whole thing. Then we're done. Thank you. All right, folks, that wraps up this really great project, this teak shoe rack. I'm really proud of it. I think it turned out really fantastic. The teak was a lot of fun to work with. It milled absolutely amazing. I know some of you will be asking me, well, you didn't put a finish on it yet. And I hope you don't get too upset with me, but I'm not going to. I'm going to leave it the way it is. I think the teak looks beautiful, natural. It's going to take on a very weathered look anyways. It's kind of a utilitarian piece, but I'm just going to leave it the way it is. And it doesn't really need a lot of protection. It already has some really nice oils. My hands have always been feeling very soft when I've been working with this. So one more thing I need to mention, totally nothing about the build itself. You might have heard some crackling sound in the last few scenes. The beard kept getting in the way of the microphone. I didn't notice it till much later on. Apparently I had it up a little high. So if you heard that crackling, that's exactly what was going on in there. Anyways, though, if you have comments, questions, suggestions, I want to hear them. mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com is how you can email me. You can leave a comment over at the show notes at mattsbasementworkshop.com. And if you're watching this at YouTube, you can leave a comment over there also. I love to hear from all of you. And maybe you have an idea for something I could do with some of that remaining teak that I have. Like I said, I've got a nice little bundle there, and I've got some ideas for a few projects I want to do, maybe coming up very soon. So until the next time, I will be talking to all of you later. Straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. To find even more videos and woodworking related content, be sure to visit our website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And don't forget to subscribe to the show either on YouTube, in iTunes, or you can even receive email notifications whenever we post something new.